Hello and welcome to another presentation by Today's. At a time when the Me Too revelations and women's safety have become the talk of the town, Baburaj starrer Koodasha offers a sneak peek into the musings and agonies of a father of a girl child. The movie, which has elements of a psycho thriller, is being directed by a debutant director. His name is Dinu Thomas, and this movie is being bankrolled by Omar and Riaz for the banner of OMR Group. In Koodasha, actor Baburaj plays the lead role. Now, there's a slight streak of villainry in his veins, it looks like. This is the actor's comeback into a serious role after a string of comic roles that he has done off late. This is a plot which is full of twists and turns. It kept on inspiring everything that was going on. There is a lot of understanding that needs to go when you start watching the movie. Baburaj has delivered a power-packed performance as a Kallukaran Joy, a goon who lives only for his daughter. It would rather be appropriate to say that it was the circumstances which made Joy, who is a widower, turn into a dreaded goon. Joy decides to give up his old ways after committing one last quotation and starts a new life with his daughter. However, something unexpected takes place which forces Joy to pursue it. The climax is thrilling and it is full of twists and surprises. You know, there is a revelation that comes towards the end which you or I would not be expecting. The audience also realizes something, and the character of Joy, he also realizes something. Assaults on women and the consequences that it creates in families, they are the crux of the movie, and that's why I mentioned Me Too at the beginning of this particular analysis. Besides, Koodasha is also about a little bit about the mental conditions like paranoia and schizophrenia. It is filled with stirring performances. Besides Baburaj, there are Aryan Krishna Menon, Karthika Pradeep, Saikumar, Joy Mathew and Devan. They play pivotal role in this particular movie. Baburaj particularly is a joy to watch as Joy. Now, this is undoubtedly one of the most amazing characters in his acting career spanning 25 years, and that is saying a lot. Somebody acting for 25 years and then coming up with the best performance of his career, best character of his career, amazing. The actor has flawlessly portrayed the agonies of a father who is disturbed by his past as well. Baburaj recently revealed that he has acted in the movie without demanding any remuneration, as he really liked the particular script. Karthika Pradeep, who debuted through the super hit movie Mohanlal, essays the role of Baburaj's daughter. Actor Aryan Krishna Menon has also performed his role with quite a bit of finesse. And I'll now talk about the director. Though it is just his debut venture, Dinu Thomas has never directed before. He has adapted a narrative style that is very unique according to me. I love the way that he has told the story. I'll say the credit of this should also go to the editing, to the cinematography, and to a large extent, the actors who have done such a good job as well. But it is the director's job to bring all of that out. Scenes which switch between the past and the present, they simulate the audience. And they show you about the mental state of the protagonist. Faisal Khalid has done an excellent camera job. Akash Joseph, his editing, according to me, is inspired. The scenes which depict crime have a unique charm that draws the attention of the audience. See, using crime and charm in the same sentence doesn't augur well. But this is there. If you see the movie, you'll see what I'm talking about. Vishnu Mohan and Hari Narayan have done the music and lyrics, and they have done an excellent job. I would like to talk about Abhijit Vijayan here. I have never had the opportunity of really sitting down and listening to him. But when I listened to the movie's song, I was reminded of my own youth when I used to hear Yesudas's songs. His voice is somewhat harks of that great singer. Now, the psycho thriller is a very, very popular theme in Malayali movies, basically. But the movie is not very high octane, if you ask me. It creates a gentle ripple in the pond rather than creating a splash. So, according to me, this movie will be liked by people who like movies like Drishyam, or people who liked slow burning movies where the story simmers and comes to the heat at the right moment. You'll enjoy this movie. I would give this movie somewhere around 3.5 to 4 out of 5, and I'll say you go ahead and watch it, because the chances are what is 4 for me could very well be 5 for you. And this is a movie that could have been a 5 even for me, had I been perhaps in a different state of mind, or had I perhaps been a native Malayali speaker and not understanding the movie via translation. I'm Anupam, and you're watching Today's. Thank you.